So here we're at Walmart, and looks nice because they have a delivery right now. I want to see what they have over here in the shelves. It looks like we got some R.E.D figures already out, which is nice. Let's see. Oh, nice. Yeah, basically that's what I was looking for. So we're gonna take one and one, and we call it a day over here. I'm gonna see over there what they have. That's it. That's all they have over here that is worth it. Welcome back to the channel. This is Dark Knight Reviews, and today's episode we're gonna look at the R.E.D. line, which is Robot Enhanced Design line. Basically, this is the second wave that is already out in the stores, which includes Cheetor and R.C.E. from Transfomers Prime and Cheetor from Beast Wars. Now, I'm not really familiar with the Transfomers Prime series. I honestly never watch it, but it looks pretty interesting, and I did some research on the Transfomers R.C.E. Prime series. So we're gonna be looking at the R.C.E. first, and let's check out the package, what it comes in. Very nice detail on it. There is the Transfomers Prime logo in there, R.C.E. For me, it was a little bit different since I'm really familiar with R.C.E. on the G1 character, and usually her colors are pink, not blue. So this kind of reminds me of Chromia, but it's okay. That, I mean, her character was the name R.C.E. on that line or that series. So as we can see over here, it's very nice. Very nice detail as far as the box, which right here you can see Robot Enhanced Design, the R.E.D. line. And we can see all the different accessories that comes with this figure, which are really nice. You can see the hands. You can see both guns. This is kind of nice. The Energon cube, that's pretty cool. I like that. And we have it over here. Her figure, pretty slick design, pretty nice design. I really like the colors and the design itself. I'm not really 100% sold on the R.E.D. line because of the first wave. I had a really disappointed figure with Optimus Prime. And Soundwave, it was okay. Megatron, I think it was much better, but obviously with this one over here, this looks a lot better compared to all of those, all the first wave, of course. So we're gonna be looking at it, the figure itself, and we're gonna find out, you know, if it's really nice, if it's not, if it's really worth it or not. And just one little detail that I noticed here, this one over here, the blade over here is supposed to be purple, but as you guys can see in there, it's just a regular color plastic. So yeah, this is just a minor detail I just noticed right now looking at the box. But anyway, we're gonna be looking at R.C.E. from Transfomers Prime. So let's start with the Dark Knight review. Okay, so here we have R.C.E. out of the package, and just a quick view of the interior of the package. Basically, this comes inside in there, which is just a blueprint of the figure itself. And as you guys can see, there's just a blueprint on it, just showing off all the different details, all the different parts of R.C.E. if she were to be taken apart. So you got the wheel, got the full figure in there. I got the blades, the gun. I think this is, yeah, this is her shoulders, her head, and such for. All right, there you go. Very nice detail about that. I didn't really notice on the previous waves. So there you go. Anyway, so here we have R.C.E. Let's look at what she comes with. Accessories. So we have the Energon cube, which is very nice. I really like this one. It's really cool, this Energon cube over here. Looks really nice. The color is just really nice, and I like that it's not really a straight square Energon cube. It's just more like a, you know, damaged Energon cube, so it's kind of like a raw, I'll say raw energy on it. So that's nice. And then we have the blades over here, which I mentioned it before, it's supposed to be purple because this is supposed to be an Energon blade, but for whatever reason they just were lazy about it, probably Hasbro or whoever is in charge of painting these parts, and they didn't really want to paint this over here. So as you guys can see in there, much more detail with my camera. Yeah, not painted at all, so yeah, that's okay, I can live with that. And I swapped the hands, the original hands that came with the figure, basically were this one's over here. But I put it with the closest face, just for the review. OK, Because this one's over here, I mean, looks like she will be holding a gun, but the gun's actually replaceable. It doesn't have anything to be holding in. So I don't know why they'll pull her finger like that, like a trigger in the gun or something. Maybe they were planning to get a third party to do a special guns for her. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what's the detail about it. I'm not sure the reason behind that. So, but it's okay. Yeah, you guys can keep it or you can just leave it in the box, whichever way. I think the closed fits looks better. And then obviously this one's over here, we replace the closed fits when you put your guns on it. Another thing about this one too, I wish they would have painted in silver just to give a little more variant on the color and just to kind of differentiate the regular plastic on her body and plastic on the guns. Same thing with the blades. I wish they would have painted in silver. Just a little details over there that, just little details that Hasbro can take a note if they ever listen to anyone. And for the next figures, they could probably just accommodate that. That would make it look really, really nice. I mean, the design is really nice. Just the color, I think, could it be better? But anyway, overall, it's nice. So let's look at the figure itself. And here we have RCEE. Very nice detail. I really like it. Like I said before, I'm not really familiar with the series, Transformers Prime, but I can see the detail on it that is really, really nice. The design is really slick. I like it. It's different from what I used to on the G1 characters. And as I mentioned before, to me, she looks more like Chromia, but it's RCEE herself on a different color, different paint. Which is nice. It's a little variant of the character. So I wish they would have the wheels to be able to turn too. But anyway, let's look at her face, which is, I love the blue eyes. Those blue eyes, look at her feet, like put the face down, and her eyes are really, really nice looking. As you can see in there, all the detail that she has. You know, the thing about this figures, the plastic that they use, it's a soft plastic, it's called PVC. It's very, very reminiscent of the Gunman figures. If you ever own a Gunman figure, if you ever play with one of them, I have a combo, kind of a couple tiny ones. Here's one, and you guys can see kind of the same type of material that this one has, which is very flexible plastic. It's not hard. As a there's another one, you know, tiny ones that I collect too as well, but you guys can see it's basically the same type of a bendable plastic that they use on this red line, which is kind of nice. I don't mind, it looks nice. Now as far as articulation with the figure, very bendable, very flexible. Now my figure, her leg is kind of loose, but I think it's just my figure, because on the other leg, she's actually more stiff. So that probably is just my figure alone. But nevertheless, it's okay. It doesn't affect how I put her in different positions or different posts. Doesn't affect that at all. So that's kind of nice. The head, you can move all the way. The shoulders are movable. You can put her in a different position. The arms can bend. The fists can move all around, and obviously you can pull them out. This area over here, I'm not sure what they were trying to accomplish with that, but the breastplate is movable. You can remove the breastplate, and it shows kind of like interior design in it, which is okay. Kind of looks creepy to me, to be honest with you. Yeah, it does look kind of creepy to me, at least. You can see the design is there now. The thing about this is that you can actually move the figure. You can see in there the joints that are with the figure, and that way you can actually bend it a little bit, but it doesn't bend that much. That's the far as it goes without the breastplate. Now, if you put the breastplate, it doesn't really go any further down. With her breastplate on it, that's the most you can go, just because this area over here, it kind of hits on the side. Also the waist is kind of nice. She has a waist movement, you can see, but it goes with the cost of this, so that means that this has to be, this is flexible. It's not attached to the body, it's just kind of put in there. So that's movable, which is okay. And yeah, the figure is a really nice figure as to post different positions, like I said before. She can stand really easy on the different ways, so that's kind of nice. Posted in a totally different look. It doesn't look right. As you guys can see, easily, she can easily post different posts in there. Although the figure is kind of delicate because it's kind of a slim body in it, you can still get a good pose out of her. Looks very nice. Now, as far as the arm or the wrist replacing the hands, you basically just kind of pull it. It's a little bit hard to pull, which is not nice, but it's okay. And then this one over here, this goes inside in there. There you go. Now we're gonna replace the other one. There we go. So that makes her look really, really intimidate her with her guns in there. And she's going in a blasting everybody in there. She looks cool like that. I gotta give it that. Out of all the figures of R.E.D., this is the nicest figure, and I wish they would have her as this slick figure, transformable. I've seen images of the transformable figure. I don't own it since I started collecting from Siege, War for Cybertron. I didn't really start with it, any of the Transformers prior to that. But I've always been a fan of Transformers, don't get me wrong. But I grew up on the G1 characters, so I'm more familiar with the G1 characters than, which RCE is a G1 character, but her design is totally brand new compared to the one that she had, which I did the review for the Kingdom one. So it's a totally different figure compared to that one. So yeah, it's very possible. Very nice looking, like I said before. So I really like this figure. Even though, like I said before, even though it doesn't transform, I'm going to keep this one just because she looks awesome. She looks great. Major upgrade from Optimus Prime R.E.D. to this one over here. Ooh, watch out, girl. All right, cool. There you go. Just looking good in there. So here we have R.E.D. along with the characters of the first wave and the second wave, Optimus Prime, Megatron, Soundwave, and Cheetor, which is the second wave partner for her on this R.E.D. line, or Red line, as some people call it. Now, in comparison to R.E.D. from Kingdom, basically she stands tall compared to her. Yeah, you can look at her. Totally different design. It's still a fan bot, but yeah, definitely a totally different design compared to the G1 character. Now, I really like this design. Honestly, like I said before, I never watched the series, but it's really interesting. I did a little research of it, of her character on that, on the Transformers Prime, and it's very interesting, her character, her story, her background. She's one of the main characters, so that's kind of nice on that. Give her props to the fanbot, the famous fanbot, the only fanbot originally from the first movie of Transformers. Now, if you guys want to find out information about her, I'll recommend, and these guys are not paying me or anything like that, basically I just listen to them. I recommend Transformers the Basics, that's a YouTube channel, and the other one is Rodimus Primal. They're very knowledgeable about the characters of the Transformers universe. So if you guys ever want to know anything about any of the figures or anything about any of the characters of Transformers, just check out their channels, and they have a vast of library of characters that they describe. And, you know, basically they talk about their backgrounds and stuff like that. So this figure, yeah, it's a totally thumbs up, a totally upgrade from what it was, Optimus Prime, with his design and with his flaws and everything. She still has a little flaws here and there, especially this one over here. That should be, that would have looked awesome if that would be purple, just like the Energon cubes in there. That would be really nice, but it's okay. It's kind of forgivable because they actually put a really nice design on it, and she's very flexible. I think she has the advantage to have a slick body and a slim body compared to the square box body that the G1 character has, and I think that it goes in her benefit. Now, I wish that if this figure itself goes into a transformable figure with this design, I will totally buy her. Honestly, it's really nice. I really like it. And like I said before, I mean, her design as it is, as a, just a display figure, is pretty cool. So just transformable, that would be really awesome. So, all right, cool. I hope you guys like this video review of RCE of Transformers Prime, or the R.E.D. line. So don't forget to sign up for, or don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and share the video. I'd really appreciate all your support, and we'll see you on the next review. Have a great day. Bye-bye.